In this video, we will cover the top 10 120mm CPU all-in-one liquid cooling unit. These are going to be units that use liquid cooling in a 120mm fan slot within your computer to cool down your processor. Before we get started, there are a few things to know. First is that in this video, we are ranking the fans in regards to their cooling performance and noise level. However, we are not considering cost and how we rank these fans. In future videos, we plan to mix what is considered so we can provide the top 10 for what matters to you. With that in mind, let's get started. At number 1, we have the Arctic Liquid Freezer 2 120. This fan is one of the cheaper fans. However, it provides higher performance per dollar relative to its peer group. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan is on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure, and is one of the quietest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the best airflow and air pressure per unit of sound. This fan has a longer warranty at 6 years and is not RGB enabled. At number 2, we have the Cooler Master Master Liquid ML120L V2 RGB. This fan is one of the pricier fans. However, it provides lower performance per dollar than its peers. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan is on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure and is one of the quietest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the best airflow and air pressures per unit of sound. This fan has a shorter warranty at 2 years and is RGB enabled. At number 3, we have the Intermax AquaFusion 120 RGB AIO. This fan has an average price. However, it provides lower performance per dollar than its peers. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan has an average airflow and air pressure and has an average noise level. When considering performance relative to sound, it has average airflow and one of the best air pressure per unit of sound. This fan has a longer warranty at 5 years and is RGB enabled. At number 4, we have the Silverstone PF120. This fan is one of the cheaper fans. However, it is one of the priciest per unit of performance of the fans reviewed. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan has high airflow with about average air pressure levels and is one of the noisiest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has an average airflow and air pressure per unit of sound. This fan has a shorter warranty at 2 years and is RGB enabled. At number 5, we have the Cooler Master Master Liquid ML120R RGB. This fan is one of the pricier fans. However, it provides lower performance per dollar than its peers. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan is on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure and has an average noise level. When considering performance relative to sound, it has an average airflow and air pressure per unit of sound. This fan has a shorter warranty at 2 years and is RGB enabled. At number 6, we have the Corsair Hydro Series H60. This fan is one of the cheaper fans. However, it is one of the priciest per unit of performance of the fans reviewed. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan is on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure and has an average noise level. When considering performance relative to sound, it has an average airflow and air pressure per unit of sound. This fan has a longer warranty at 5 years and is not RGB enabled. At number 7, we have the ASUS ROG Strix LC120. This fan is one of the pricier fans. However, it provides lower performance per dollar than its peers. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan has about an average airflow with above average air pressure levels and is one of the noisiest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and average air pressure per unit of sound. This fan has a longer warranty at 5 years and is RGB enabled. At number 8, we have the Corsair Hydro Series H80i V2. This fan is one of the cheaper fans. However, it is one of the priciest per unit of performance of the fans reviewed. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan has about an average airflow with above average air pressure and is one of the noisiest. When considering performance relative to sound, it is one of the worst airflow and has average air pressure per unit of sound. This fan has a longer warranty at 5 years and is not RGB enabled. At number 9, we have the Thermaltake TH120A RGB Sync. This fan is one of the cheaper fans. However, it is one of the priciest per unit of performance of the fans reviewed. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan is on the lower end of both airflow and air pressure and has average noise levels. When considering performance relative to sound, it has average airflow and one of the worst air pressure per unit of sound. This fan has a shorter warranty at 3 years and is RGB enabled. At number 10, we have the NZXT Kraken N22. This fan is one of the pricier fans. However, it provides lower performance per dollar than its peers. In terms of airflow, air pressure, and noise level, this fan has about average airflow and air pressure and is one of the noisiest. When considering performance relative to sound, it has one of the worst airflow and air pressure per unit of sound. This fan has a shorter warranty at 3 years and is RGB enabled. Now that we have covered the top 10 fans in detail, we will cover the summary of the fans reviewed. As we look at the table, it can be difficult to see how each of them ranks among their peers. With that in mind, I have shown bar charts for a handful of the key metrics, including airflow, air pressure, and the bottom of the charts comparing these metrics relative to sound. Additionally, we have provided a noise level and radiator size graph to make these easier to compare. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed my video, please remember to subscribe, like, and comment, and any feedback on my videos in the comment section is appreciated.